بالله من الشيطان الرجيم الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to Merciful Servant. In this particular verse, we're going to be talking about the last part of the verse, which is Wallahu yuhibbul muhsinin, and Allah loves the doer of good, or Allah loves those people that have excellent amal or excellent character. Now, in order for us to understand this verse, we need to understand what ihsan is. Now, ihsan, concept of excellence in Islam, is of two types towards people. One is that you benefit them, so you bring any benefit to the people. The second type of ihsan is that you take away anything that is going to harm them. So we find that the first part of this verse, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ, those that spend in the way of Allah in ease and in hardship, is pertaining to the first element of ihsan, which is we're bringing benefit to people, whether it is through our money, whether it is through our ilm, whether it is through our knowledge, whether it is through resources, skills, whatever it is, we are going to benefit the people. So they spend, and the spending is part of ihsan. The second element of ihsan is that we take away something that is going to harm them. And in this, there's two types. One is we take away something that is going to harm them in this dunya. And the other is we take away something that is going to harm them in the akhirah. And subhanAllah, the second part of this verse is وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْفِ, and those that suppress anger. When we suppress our anger and we stop ourselves from bursting out into this emotional storm and hurting somebody's feeling, or maybe get into physical fight or something when we get angry, when we suppress that emotion of anger, we have taken away that harm that was naturally supposed to come to this particular individual, and we took it away only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second part is taking away something that's going to harm an individual's akhirah. And that is the last part of the verse, which is وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, and those that forgive people. If we did not forgive this particular individual for whatever he has done wrong to me or to you or to anyone else, then on the day of judgment, yes, we could take our revenge. Yes, we could get up and say, you know what? Alhamdulillah, this is our chance. You know, I kept quiet on that day, but today I'm going to take you on. We could do that, but then we have not done ihsan towards that individual. And that is why we need to forgive him, so that on the day of judgment, no harm comes to any human beings through us. And this is the highest category of ihsan. A beautiful story is mentioned whenever this particular verse comes, which is the story of Hassan ibn Ali, the son of Ali radiallahu anhu. He was sitting with his guests, and there were some elite guests that were there. And one of his servants, he brought a qidr, he brought a pot full of hot food. And when he placed that hot food on the ground, he was about to place it, it slipped from his hand. And when it slipped, splashes of this food came onto Hassan radiallahu anhu. Now, as a servant, you know, obviously he's afraid that, you know, my master, and you know, he said, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظِ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. So, Hassan radiallahu anhu, he says, I have forgiven you and I shall not take any revenge from you. And then he says, Wallahu yuhibbul muhsinin. The servant completes the verse, and then Hassan ibn Ali, he says, indeed, I have let you go as my slave, you're free, you're no longer my slave. Rather, I will get you married to this particular daughter, and whatever you're going to require for your lives, to make your lives happy and livable, is going to be on my sustenance. And this is the highest category of ihsan. So I hope that, you know, you benefited from this. I'd like to hear from you. Do you have some amazing stories or some interesting incidents about ihsan, about any of what I've mentioned over here? If you do, please mention it in the comments below. Lastly, do not forget to share this video with all your friends. Do ihsan to this video. Benefit their this dunya and benefit their akhirah also. And lastly, make dua for me and for all the people at Merciful Servant that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts from me and them and all of the viewers this Ramadan and all the fasting in it. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Astaghfiruka wa atubu alayk. Until next time.